In this lesson, I'm going to demystify the increasingly complex subject of operating systems, devices, and office versions. So what exactly is an operating system? You're probably using Excel 2013 on a Windows 7 or Windows 8.1 personal computer. Windows is an operating system. When Excel 2013 needs to do something, such as open a file, it does so by sending a request to the Windows operating system. The Windows operating system intimately understands all of the hardware in your computer, so it's able to take the request to open a file and go to the relevant hard drive and open it for you. It then sends that file back to Excel, and Excel is able to display it on the computer screen. If Excel 2013 was to send the same request to Apple's OS X operating system, that's used on Apple computers, the request would have to be very different. The Mac OS X operating system wouldn't understand what Excel was trying to ask it to do. If it sent the same request, it would send to Windows. For this reason, Microsoft produce a rewritten version of Office that runs on the Apple OS X operating system. The Office Mac versions send requests to the Mac OS X operating system that it understands, so everything works perfectly. At the time of recording this video, in June of 2014, the latest Office version available for the Mac was Office 2011. The Apple versions of Office are significantly different to their Windows counterparts. Now let's move on to smartphones. What exactly is a smartphone? A smartphone is a mobile telephone that also includes a computer and a touchscreen. Lightweight mobile operating systems have been specially designed for smartphones. Also, small programs, commonly referred to as apps, have been developed to run on these mobile operating systems. There are three common smartphone operating systems: Apple's iOS, that's only used on iPhones; Google's Android, that's used on the majority of other smartphones; and Microsoft's Windows Phone operating system, that's a relative newcomer to the market. Some apps have been released in three different versions, so that a version is available for all three operating systems. Now let's move on to tablet computers. What exactly is a tablet computer? Apple's iPad, launched in 2010, was the first mass-market modern tablet computer. A tablet computer is similar to a very large smartphone, though most don't have telephony capability. Screen sizes are typically 7 or 10 inches, and just like a smartphone, they're usually controlled via a touchscreen. Some tablet computers have an optional keyboard available as an add-on. Tablet operating systems are similar to their smartphone counterparts. That's Apple's iOS, only used on the iPad, Google's Android, and a special Windows 8 version called Windows 8 RT. You now have a good overview of the main operating systems in use today. For desktop computers, we have the Windows operating system and the Mac OS X operating system, only used on Apple computers. And as mentioned earlier, Excel 2013 won't run on a Mac computer, though there are special Mac versions of Office available. Next, we have the smartphones. The iOS operating system is only used on Apple's iPhone. The second most widely used operating system at the moment is the Android operating system, and the Windows Phone operating system is a relative newcomer to the market. Finally, we have the pad devices. The iOS operating system is only used on iPad devices. The Android operating system is used on most other pad devices. And the most recent entry into the market is the Windows 8 RT operating system. So now you have a good overview of all of the operating systems in general use today. Let's move on to Office 2013 versions. First of all, there's the desktop version of Excel 2013. This is the full version of Office that you probably have installed on the hard drive of your PC. The Office 2013 desktop version will only run on the Windows 7 and Windows 8 or later operating systems. There's also a version of Office 2013 that runs on the Windows 8 RT operating system. You'll remember that this is the operating system installed on some pad devices. This is almost identical to the full desktop version, but there are some small differences caused by the technical limitations of Windows 8 RT. A very interesting new Office 2013 version is Office Online. Office Online is a cloud-based suite of applications accessed via your OneDrive. This means that the Office Online applications don't even need to be installed on your computer or device. And the most amazing thing about the Office Online suite of Office applications is that they're completely free of charge. That means you don't need to own a version of Office or have an Office 365 subscription in order to be able to freely use them all. Because these Office versions are not installed on your computer, they don't care which operating system you're using. So they'll run on absolutely all of the operating systems. The third version of Office 2013 is Office Mobile. This is a version of Office intended for mobile phones, and it's been designed with very small screen sizes in mind. Office Mobile is included free on all Windows 8 phone devices. This is a big selling point for Windows 8 phones. Office Mobile is also available for some, but not all, Android devices, both pads and phones. In order to download the Android Office Mobile app, you will need an Office 365 subscription. And finally, there's now an Office Mobile version available for Apple's iOS operating system. This means that you can run Office 2013 on iPads and iPhones. But once again, you'll need an Office 365 subscription in order to download and use the app. And you've now completed Lesson 8.3. Understand operating systems, devices, and Office versions.